for the Ram Navami celebration, because going to constrain, we are doing the ceremony on life. So, because of the situation, so today the appearance day of Lord Ramachandra Bhagavan, devotees have been fasting for the whole day to appreciate the appearance of the Lord. So, because Ramayanam is a very interesting Puranam. Actually, it's a itihasa. There are two itihasas, Mahabharata and Ramayanam. The Ramayanam that we have now, how many verses are there in the Ramayanam now?
25,000.
How much? 25,000. Looks like there's another Ramayana going on. I thought Ravana came and saw me. He was so fierce, I thought he was in the mood of Ravana. So this Ramayanam that we are originally there in the spiritual world, I mean in Lord Brahma's place, is 1 billion verses. So cut short to 25,000. Still then also no time.
24,000.
To do 25,000 verses, no time. So, of course, all of you are familiar with Lord Ram's pastime. Primarily, it is explained here. There's a verse here, a few verses that we like to read. Maybe you want to chant, it's a bit long to chant. So we read the English. Sri Sukadeva Goswami said, "My dear king, in Kim Purusha Varsa, the great devotee Hanuman is always engaged with the inhabitants of that land in devotional service to Lord Ramachandra, the elder brother of Lakshman and dear husband of Sita Devi." So in the Kim Purusha Varsa, that is adjacent to our Bharata Varsha, ours is in Jambudip. This is Kim Purusha, you know, another tract of land. Hanuman is staying there. When you say Kim Purusha, what man? Kim means what? Purusha means man. What man? Because they are half animal and half human. And then they have the other planet called Kinnaras. Kinnara. Kinnara. Again. What man, you know, they have the head of the animal, the body of a man. Here they have the head of a animal, the body of a man. So two different planets are there. So Hanuman is there and is glorifying the Lord. A host of Gandharvas is always engaged in chanting the glories of Lord Ramachandra. That chanting is always extremely auspicious. Hanumanji and Arishtasena, the chief person in Kim Purusha Varsa, constantly hear those glories with complete attention, Anuman chant the following mantras. This is the sloka that he chants, Anuman. Om Namo Bhagavate Uttam Slokaya Nama Arya Lakshmana Lakshana Sila Vartaye Nama Upasikshitatmana Upasita Lokaya Namaha Sadhu Vadha Nikasanaya Namo Brahmanya Devaya Mahapurushaya Maharajaya Nama Iti. So the translation, let me please your lordship by chanting the Bija Mantra Omkara. I wish to offer my respectful obeisance unto the personality of Godhead who is the best among the most highly elevated personalities. Your lordship is the reservoir of all good qualities of Aryans, people who are advanced. Your character and behavior are always consistent, and you always control your senses and mind. Acting just like an ordinary human being, you exhibit exemplary character to teach others how to behave. There is a touchstone that can be used to examine the quality of gold, but you are like touchstone that can verify all good qualities. You are worshipped by Brahmanas, you are foremost of all devotees, you are the Supreme Person, are the King of Kings, and therefore I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. The Lord whose pure form, Sachidananda Vigraha, is uncontaminated by the modes of material nature, can be perceived by pure consciousness. In the Vedanta, He is described as one without a second. Because of His spiritual potency, He is untouched by the contamination of material nature. Because He is not subject to material vision, He is known as transcendental. He has no material activities, nor has He a material form or name. Only in pure consciousness, Krishna consciousness, can one perceive the transcendental form of the Lord. Let us be firmly fixed in the lotus feet of Lord Ramachandra, and let us offer our respectful obeisance unto the transcendental lotus feet. It is ordained that Ravana, the chief of the Rakshasas, could not be killed by anyone but a man. And for this reason, Lord Ramachandra, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, appeared in the form of a human being. Lord Ramachandra's mission, however, was not only to kill Ravana, but also to teach mortal beings that material happiness centers around sex life or centered around one's wife is the cause of many miseries. Sloka. See that? He is the self-sufficient Supreme Personality of Godhead, and nothing is lamentable for Him. Therefore, why else could He be subject to tribulation by the kidnapping of Mother Sita? His old Ramayana is based on this point. See that? So, important lesson. Since Lord Sri Ramachandra, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vasudev, is not attached to anything in this material world, He is the most beloved super soul of all realized souls and is their very intimate friend. He is full of all opulence, therefore He could not possibly have suffered because of separation from His wife, nor could He have given up His wife and Lakshman, His younger brother. To give up either would have been Him. Absolutely impossible. One cannot establish a friendship with the Supreme Lord Ramachandra on the basis of material qualities such as one's birth in an aristocratic family, one's personal beauty, one's eloquence, one's sharp intelligence, or one's superior race or nation. None of this qualification is actually a prerequisite for friendship with Lord Ramachandra. Otherwise, how is it possible that although we uncivilized inhabitants of the forest have not taken noble birth, although we have no physical beauty and although we cannot speak like gentlemen, Lord Ramachandra has nevertheless accepted us as friends. Therefore, whether one is a demigod or a demon, a man or a creature other than man, such as a beast or bird, everyone should worship Lord Ramachandra, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who appears on this earth just like a human being. There is no need of great austerities or penance to worship the Lord, for he accepts even a small service offered by his devotee. Thus he is satisfied, and as soon as he is satisfied, the devotee is successful. Indeed, Lord Sri Ramachandra brought all the devotees of Ayodhya back home, back to Godhead, Vaikuntha. For that, simply by offering a little service. So, of course, right now we all are facing a dilemma. We are having this virus problem, and of course we are all very much anticipating some vaccine or some, what call that? Some kind of a medicine, correct? To be invented by some scientist, somebody. Yes? But actually, the real vaccine is in the hands of the Lord. You know? And this is why the Lord appears periodically to have us have that faith. To come to that understanding that He, to surrender to Him is the remedial measure for all problems. You know? See, this is actually spoken by the Lord Himself. And this verse. This verse He sang. That one, 11:29, you can cry, no use. 11:29, in time of trouble someone may be crying. 11:29:21. So in this verse you see, O Uddhava, greatest of saints, in a dangerous situation an ordinary person cries, becomes fearful and laments. Although such useless emotion do not change the situation, but activities offered to me without personal motivation, even if they are extremely useless, amount to the actual process of religion. See this point here? So, we are faced with so many calamities, especially now. Everyone is very uncertain. Yes, so many precautions have been taken. But in this situation, if we can understand the potency of the Lord, the power of the Lord, and surrender to Him, then everything becomes just. You know. In fact, in the sixth canto, anyone who chants the name Rama, even once, and say that I have now surrendered to you, from that day onwards, I give him all protection. You know, I think in 6:2. So you see how 22? Sakrareva prapanam yes tava smiti yichaya yachate abhayam sarvadata smay tadami tarvatam mama. So it is my vow that if one, only one, seriously surrenders on me, saying, my dear Lord, from this day I am yours, and prays to me for courage, I shall immediately award courage to that person. And he will always remain safe from that time on. See? So now this is why there are calamities. The calamities are coming for us to come to this point, to take shelter of the Lord. Yes. If there is no problem, then who will take to shelter of the Lord? Yes? And that is the only solution for everything. To come to the point of surrendering to the... And when you do that, you see, then the Lord says, he will always remain safe from that time on. It's the assurance of the Lord. Even in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, no? Correct? Kauntaya pratijane ma bhakta pranashati. That's why he came, he showed. Someone who didn't take shelter of him, he tried to become too smart like Ravana. What happened? Ravana was so bold, he kidnapped Sita. Can you imagine his audacity? He didn't care. And when he heard that Ram was landing in Lanka, coming with some monkeys, he was laughing. Monkeys. What's he going to do? And he, you see, usually when you go to war, all the generals go. But you know, you just send one of his generals, you go and deal with this problem. See, huh? Because he's thinking, when he got the benediction, he said that I cannot be what? Killed by any animal, any demigod. He didn't use the word human. You know, human beings, what is there? Can't, nothing there, useless. That much he was. That's why Lord Ram has to come as a human being to kill him. And he came. And see, there's another verse, I think it is in the Ramachandra's story part in the Bhagavatam. You can take out for me. That Ravana, because he did not get the blessings of Sita, he was offending. The monkeys could kill him with just throwing stones. Just by throwing some stones and some trees, could kill his man. Although his man had all material weapons, you know, because he got the curse. Finish. Now, we are hearing one part that if you surrender and just once only say, Ram, I am surrendering, right? See, just once.
9, 10, 20.
I will come to that. It is my vow that if one, only one surrenders unto me, saying, my dear Lord, from this day I am yours. Just once only. And prays to me for courage, I shall immediately award courage to that person and he will always remain safe from that time on. See that point? And now, Ravana on the other hand, he went ahead, he did curse, he got cursed. And you see what happened? What the verse?
9.10.20.
9.10.20, yeah? I think the purpose, no? Angada and other commanders of the soldiers of Ramachandra faced the elephants, infantry, horses and chariots of the enemy and hurled against them big trees, mountain peaks, clubs and arrows. Thus the soldiers of Lord Ramachandra kill Ravana's soldiers who had lost all good fortune because Ravana had been condemned by the anger of Mother Sita. See? The Purport Prabhupada is writing. The soldiers Lord Ramachandra recruited in the jungle were all monkeys and did not have proper equipment with which to fight the soldiers of Ravana. For Ravana's soldiers were equipped with weapons of modern warfare, whereas the monkeys could only throw stone, mountain peaks and trees. It is only Lord Ramachandra and Lakshmana who shot some arrows. No point. But because the soldiers of Ravana were condemned by the curse of Mother Sita, the monkeys were able to kill them simply by throwing stones and trees. There are two kinds of strength, Deva and Purushakara. Purushakara, Deva refers to the strength achieved from the transcendence, and Purushakara refers to strength organized by one's own intelligence and power. Transcendental power is always superior to the power of materialists. Depending on the mercy of the Supreme Lord, one must fight one's enemy even though one may not be equipped with modern weapons. Therefore, Krishna instructed Arjuna, Mam Anusmara Yuddhaya Cha. Think of me and fight. We should fight our enemy to the best of our ability, but for victory we must depend on the mercy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. See this point? Yeah? You understand this point? So we are all now faced with the dilemma. I don't know who will get the disease. I get it. Anyone. And we get it. Chances come out. It's also very, especially for older people, very slim chance. So this is very important. We understand this instruction. We are all very vulnerable. That's why in the material world, what is that verse? Padam padam vipadam natesham. 10, 14, 58. You see here, this verse is quoted many times by Prabhupada. What time is it? 9 o'clock finish, yeah? Oh, I'm sorry, for those who have accepted the boat of the shelter, boat of the lotus feet of the Lord with the shelter of the cosmic manifestation is famous as Murari, the enemy of the Mura demon. The ocean of material world is like water contained in a calf's hoof print. Their goal is Param Padam, Vaikuntha, the place where there is no material miseries, not the place where there is danger at every step. This material world is Padam Padam Vipadam Natesha. Vipadam means danger, always in a dangerous position. So we need to learn how to take shelter. That's why the Lord descends. Why he has to come here? No need to come here, right? He is happy down there, correct? Why he comes? Why? And because to show that we need to surrender to him. And how he used this example? He used some monkeys. Huh? That's why in the beginning verse, the Lord, you know, just now we read, no? Huh? If we are ugly, we have no good bodily feature, nothing, and the Lord accepted us. Huh? You see the point. So the Lord is for the most fallen. Anybody, and we all in Kali Yuga, especially all of us are very fallen. Patita Pavan Hetu, very fallen. Okay. So the thing is, that we all should follow this example, trying to accept the Lord's mercy. Because you never say that you don't now sit down and just 24 hours. No, you have to also do your work. That's why Prabhupada writes in the purport that's now. Yes, you fight, as Krishna also said, that is in 8-7, is it? Yeah. Krishna says here that you fight. But you must think of me. Yeah? Tasmat sarveshu kaleshu mam anusmara yuddhaya cha mayarpitu mana buddhi mam evasya asya samsaya. Therefore, Arjuna, you should always think of me in the form of Krishna. At the same time, carry out your prescribed duty of fighting. with your activities dedicated to me and your mind and intelligence fixed on me, you will attain me without doubt. So we should understand this thing, that we not just we sit idle and just say, alright, pray to God and that's it. No. We have to also act accordingly. Same time, our whole, what we say, dependence is on the mercy of the... Because this comes to my mind that some group of people went and they say, so God will protect me and I don't care. And apparently they all got the virus. So now coming to this point, then how do you reconcile this? Yeah, depending on God, God will protect me and they all got the virus. How is it possible? Right? So this comes to my mind, the story of his man, the brahmachari. He is totally dependent on God and he was going on the road. And while he was going, people were running across and he's saying, hey, go back, go back. Then why go back? God will protect me, no problem. The man, elephant is coming, you go back. No, 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 God will protect me, he said that. So then he went, and he went, and people still tell him, hey, run away, come on. Those from Kerala will know what is mad elephant. There are so many elephants in Kerala. And then he went, and he got trampled by the elephant. Lucky the elephant let him alive. He came back with broken bones and hand and everything to the guru in the ashram. Hey, Guru Maharaj, what is this? I totally dependent on God. And I went. And now you see this has happened. Why the Lord did not protect me? Then this guru in the ashram, what happened? No, no, I was going. And then the people were all shouting, go back, go back. No, I depended on the God and I went. And then I got trampled. So why didn't God protect me? You are a fool. Guru, what? I'm a fool. Already broken hand, everything, and get chastised some more by the guru. A fool. Eh? Why? What happened? Say, you are a fool. Don't you think God is protecting you? God is telling you to go away. How he tells? He told by all the people coming, they were telling you. God didn't come directly and speak to you, my dear son. Kissing on the cheek and... What? He said he is what? People in the heart, he is telling you, go. And this guy is thinking that God must personally... What? So this kind of intelligence, that is not supported. Understand? Trying to kind of vainly use, this is an offense, to use the holy name, right? And commit offenses. So this is the thing that now God will protect me and you go. How you know God will protect you? Are you what? That close with God? Shaking hands with him and talking with him every day? What? And not only that, our mood, the devotee, we are different. We always don't want to give trouble to God. That is not our... You understand? Our thing is to not make... Put God in the spot, you know. Put God in the... And that's not our... Ours is not just one story, another story there. That I think, who was it? He was always chanting in the hot sun. Writing his book in the hot sun, one of the Goswamis. I don't remember. Who? Who is that? And Sanatan came, and he saw him. And he saw him, you know, writing in the hot sun. And he doesn't want to build a little hut. And he was seeing Radharani is holding a sari on top of him. Who is that? Yeah? Huh? Raghunath Das writing? Yeah. Anyway, I don't know the name, but if you know, you can help me. So then, Sanatana, what? You giving trouble to the Lord. Why are you doing this? Huh? And another time he came, he saw him, that Krishna was, you know, he was in the hot, dry writing, and then on the side, Krishna was holding an arrow, a bow and arrow, and that side was a tiger. I said, what are you doing? You're giving trouble to Krishna. You understand? So the devotee is in this mood that we don't want to put the Lord in. The Lord said, no, he, what? My devotee will never perish. Huh? And you go out without the mask and you anybody coughing you. Superman. Huh? Yeah? I mean, you have to use some intelligence. You know this is not good. Huh? Take precaution. And of course, always depending on the Lord. That's crucial. And we depend on the Lord even we are no potency, like the monkeys. They are nothing. Ravana's soldiers were all well trained. They had what? Mantras, you know. They could chant mantras and finish everything. But because they have no blessing, then everything was finished. Ravana was defeated. When he came and he was defeated, he went back home. Ram said, never mind, you go back. You go back and you think it over and return Sita. That's all. And when he came back to his palace, he was so broken hearted. Because he was defeated. Everything is finished. Then he decided to wake Kumbhakarna up. Still he was planning. You understand? This is, we don't want to do this kind of things. No. We just want to surrender. And by surrendering, you get everything, correct? Yes, you see. By surrendering, the soldiers were all killed. Ram would come in the night and you would glance and all the soldiers would wake up again. Except Ravana soldiers, of course, they couldn't wake up. They were killed. You understand? See? So this is the power of God, you know. God can do anything. Okay? So why he has gone this situation about our calamity now with the present situation? And make us become more, what we say, surrender. Okay? Take shelter of the Lord more. Become more convinced of the Lord's mercy. Then by doing that, because he is saying we will sail through, we have no problem. But we should always depend on his mercy. We should not take advantage of that. That we should not do. You understand this? This is very important. So this guarantee of the Lord, I don't want to take so much time. I think today we don't have such a time span. You're all going to break your fast. So I think this is very important. And this also reminds me of this verse. That all of you, I think, most probably know. Balasya neha sharanam pitarav narishimha natasya chagadam udhavyanti majjato no taptasya tad prativittekya ihanja seshta tavad vibhotanum prittam tvat upekshitanam. This word upekshitanam is very important, no? It means neglected. Tvat upekshitanam, who are neglected by you and not accepted by you. My Lord Narasimhadev, O Supreme, because of your body, of a bodily conception life, embodied soul neglected and not cared for you, cannot do anything for their betterment. Whatever remedies they accept, although perhaps temporarily beneficial, are certainly impermanent. For example, a father and mother cannot protect their child. A physician and medicine cannot relieve a suffering patient. And a boat on the ocean cannot protect a drowning man. So this, if the Lord neglects, then nothing can help us. So this is a very important lesson today, the appearance day of Lord Ramachandra, that we understand that we need to take shelter of the Lord. And we need to develop our loving relationship with Him. That is very crucial. That's why the Lord appears periodically to teach us. This is the important point. Alright, I'm not taking much of your time. I'm going to break your fast. Any questions? Questions?
So, the material strength and spiritual strength. So, those soldiers of Ram were not very sophisticated. But then we also hear the Prabhupada saying that to catch the thief, we need to have the same power. Like if he's running on a motorbike and you run on a cycle, you can't catch him. So in that way, we use Yukta Vairagya and we use all the modern amenities for professional service. So why don't we just do the traditional way and we don't use anything? Because it will be more powerful than material power. Why the Yukta Vairagya?
No, you first have to get the sanction of Ram to use your old way. If you have sanction by Ram, then you can use peaks and trees and all that. But the main thing is that you get to get connected to the Lord. It's not the method so much, it's the connection. If you're connected to the Lord, just like Balaram, you just use the grass and you killed, what's his name? Yeah, the Lord. So if you're connected, just like Arjuna, he could use all his weapons and shoot everybody dead. But when the Lord withdrew that thing, he could not even use nothing. So we need to understand our connection with God is more crucial. And we are connected and we get His mercy, then yes, why stone, rocket, this, that, proper road in one of the purport, the missiles also can be used. You know? So that connection is essential. That's why in this purport, because they were what? Blessed by Ram. And Ravana, on the other hand, although he had the sophisticated elements, equipment, he was cursed by Sita, by her anger. So these two parallels we have to study. So if we are blessed by, like for example, here, actually our movement is blessed by Prabhupada and Krishna. And because Prabhupada's mercy, we could use anything for preaching. You see? But when we are not blessed by Him, then whatever you use, it will not work. Okay? So that connection is essential. You know, not so much so that you're trying to catch the thief and you have to go and get some big car. Yeah, you can try on your own account, but it will not work. But if you use the devi means connecting with God. And that connection with the spiritual mother is very crucial. Then yes, by their blessing, well, you can use anything and everything. Why not? But without their blessing, even a simple thing, you cannot even perform. But that is the crucial, I would say, connection, mercy. Otherwise,
next question is,
Vishwadeva also praying that, you know, that Krishna glances over the Kaurava army, they reduce their life. At the time of death, when you are praying, Lord glances over the Kaurava army, although they have power to reduce their life.
That's why the verse, no, once you are neglected by the Lord, then nothing can work. I think you all know this verse, no? One who is, what? If Krishna wants to kill someone, no one can save him. And if Krishna wants to save someone, nobody can kill him. Huh? Rakeka? That's the verse.
But if, so devotees died with this virus or other ways. So is that Krishna neglecting them or even Prabhupada passed away? Did Krishna neglect him?
Transcendental personalities, anyone who chant, don't come under the jurisdiction of common karmic laws. They are on a different parallel altogether. A devotee who dies and a non-devotee who dies is two different things. That's why it's explained. The cat carrying the kitten and the cat carrying the mouse. One is out of fear, where it's his next destination. But for devotee is different, is on a different. That's why Krishna says, even then, Arjuna asked the question, what happens to the devotee if he fails? Oh, Krishna says, no loss for him. He'll go to the heavenly planet, enjoy, and come back and take birth in high aristocratic family, yes, or some very great devotee family, and he can continue again.
So the neglect or not depends more after death also.
Yes, Krishna for devotees, he says, my devotee will not perish means my devotee will not perish. How he addresses that, that is Krishna's jurisdiction. Our job is to surrender. Whether I go back or not go back, a devotee, that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu teaching us, you know. What is that? Whether you save me or you kill me, it doesn't matter. You are my prananath. That is our training. But whether Krishna wants to save us or not save us, that is, we leave it to Krishna. Just like Prabhupada, when he was leaving, Prabhupada, you please ask Krishna to, you know, prolong your life. That's Krishna's wish. The devotee thinks like that's Krishna's wish. You want to save me or you want this? Up to him. See? But out of humility, say, but you pray to Krishna to keep me, then yes. Yeah, but he doesn't pray. You know, Krishna, please give me, I've got very important work to do, I've got to deliver the whole world. And he doesn't do that. You understand? This is humility. Vaishnavas, how we act. Just like this story I gave, Krishna will protect me. That's not humility. You understand? And surely, Krishna will give you some headache, and you know. So therefore, the body is a different category altogether. So once you are a devotee, that's it. So he said that Arjuna, he said, you all succumb, you become a devotee. Be my devotee. Right? Yes or not? 6, 20, 40, 6 and 47, 46. All succumb, you be my devotee. Why? Because becoming a devotee means a different, Krishna already puts you on a different category.
Next question. In that case of the elephant attacking the villagers, so all those people who were listening, warning him, they were all non-devotees. And why should we take the opinion of the non-devotees at this time, whereas when the brahmachari actually joined full time, there would have been many non-devotees who said, no, you should not join full time, no, you should work also, otherwise how you may maintain, and why we should not hear them that time? Why
here and
this time? Now it's Krishna speaking, then it's not Krishna speaking.
That's a different situation.
But he surrendered to Krishna.
He surrendered to Krishna, but he had to take direction from his guru, Sadhu Sastra Guru. Yeah, in this situation, it was an emergency. And Krishna is speaking through, there could be some devotees also in the group. You cannot say all are non-devotees.
Maybe those devotees don't have faith. What kind of devotees is taking advice from?
You see, you have to use your intelligence also, you know. Not that you go around and say, I have faith in Krishna and somebody is, some animal is coming and people warning you and they are running. Why you should use it? Why everybody is running? Huh? No, there's a mad elephant coming. You have to have some non-devotee tell you that. Anybody can tell you that. Correct?
Another example is in Krishna's life, when he was going to America, the Sumati Maharaji said, you are old man, you are going to die, it's so cold there. But he did not listen, he just went, he depended on Krishna and he went. And he suffered heart attack, but still he went.
Actually, Krishna could have arranged a plane ticket for him, you know. Why didn't Krishna arrange a plane ticket? Because by going on the ship, he became more glorious.
But he did not take Sumati Maharaj's advice that he will die.
Because he was determined to spread this message. Because of that determination, I'm sitting here and you are sitting here. If he did not do that, I won't be here, you won't be here.
So that was to...
Krishna had a plan. Actually, he said, if I get one more heart attack, I'll die. And actually, he said confidentially to devotees that Krishna came and was massaging him.
So that was to fulfill the order of his guru. So
he wanted to go to America by all means. He was determined. Prabhupada said that. He said, my enthusiasm, I am very enthusiastic. If I was not enthusiastic, I wouldn't have come to America. And Prabhupada, even as I can see myself, I am 65, coming to 65, and see how much my body is in a mess. I mean, at 69, taking a boat, I mean, anyone can put two together, you know. It's going to be a slim chance. You're going to survive that kind of roller coaster ride. I mean, Prabhupada was so determined. I mean, what is going with him and Krishna, I cannot say. for someone like Prahlad Maharaj to jump off the cliff. His throne, okay. And willingly go, you know, because he seeing Krishna all the time. That's why he could do it, you know. It says in that verse, when, what's his name, the father, or grandfather, what's his name? Hiranyakashipu's father, what is his son? Kashyapa Muni, yes? Kashyapa Muni was speaking to, what's her name? Diti. Said, this boy, your grandson, yeah? He is different from others. Others will know God is in the heart, but this boy will be seeing God in the heart of everybody. You will be seeing God. There's a difference. So when you are seeing God, then what you cannot do? What you will not do. That's the difference. But when you're not seeing God, then you are question mark. So what level Prabhupada is in? I mean, definitely to become so confident, he must have some relationship with Krishna that I cannot say. And if he can tell us in briefly, I saw the 10 avatars come and pull the boat. Huh? 10 avatars come to you and pull your boat. Huh? What? The 10 avatars song we are singing, all are sleeping. Anyway. And then he said further that Krishna came and massaged my heart and said, don't worry, everything you. I mean, this usually they will not tell you. But it's, why he says? Give an understanding. His position is different. I mean, don't talk so much. You take one kartal and go to some Chinatown or Little India, whatever, and play and see if you can bring 50 guys here. Please. You understand? And you can see, you, I don't know, because you were not, I mean, I can't say, but I my experience, I was there. I joined in 75. Like, you know, the mood is very different. Every one of us were on fire. That we will do anything. That was our, you know what I mean? Enthusiasm. Because it's from Prabhupada. There's a difference. It's so powerful. I mean, he is an empowered person, there's no doubt about it. And he writes confidentially also in many places in the CC, Satyavesh Avatar. You know, you do not know, you know, that one who has got the, what? Krishna Shakti Vina, Nai Parvartana. He was speaking so many places. He was trying to give some, you know, glimpse about actually not an ordinary person. Of course, if someone like you and me got one, better I don't take the ship. Can you give me a plane ticket instead? You know, probably will ask, yes? Why? This is Krishna's way of exemplifying his character, to show how he is. You understand? If he had just taken a plane and landed in New York or something, so what, you know? You understand? Yeah, she could have, but she gave him a free ticket on the ship. She didn't even suggest, why don't you go by plane, I'll pay the ticket. She didn't say that also. So this is Krishna's plan. A pure devotee, that's why, what is that verse? Mahatmanasnu mam partha devim pakirtin asritiyam. My devotees are protected by the divine energy. And the same thing, yeah, Anuman, you know. Oh, protected by, I mean, how to fight with people who throw all kind of astras. Ravana, he had Indra all in his pocket. Yamaraj was under his seat. Yamaraj is under his seat. Can you imagine how much powerful he was? And Anuman, what he had? Of course, he had mystic power. Others, monkeys, nothing. So this is the essence, the lessons of Ramayana, to understand. Even you have no sophistication, even you are nothing. But if you surrender, that's now you read the verse. Even once if you just say, I am your servant Ram, sit, finish. Everything is settled. That is power of God. Don't underestimate God's power. That's the point. You cannot. God is God. We are some tiny little what? Living entity. What we can do? But that's why the verse, Mukham Karoti Vachalam, Pangum Langayate Girim, correct? The what? The dumb can speak and the lame can cross over mountain if they have the mercy of Sri Guru Dina Tarana, by the mercy of the Guru. Anything can happen. So that is what we are now trying to secure. Our whole spiritual life is based on this point. How to please Guru and through him how to please Krishna. This is all our program. Then yes, whatever is impossible will become possible. Right? I mean, you can see, we are not going to glorify Singapore. How difficult? Impossible? Yes. But by the mercy of Prabhupada, today, possible? Who could imagine? Who could imagine Ratha Yatra getting so many people? Who could imagine? That is all by His. If He desires, everything is done. So that is what spiritual life is all about. How to understand, get the mercy of Guru and Krishna. Then yes, then any material condition we don't have to worry. Nothing. That is how we should understand spiritual life. Not understand in another way. Oh, they have promised already, so I will go ahead. That is something else. Yes?
Next question. Rakshisatite Vishwaso, one of the aspects of surrender is that the Lord will protect. And Gopal says in one place that one should not take sannyas if he has no faith in protection of the Lord, because he is going to be so called alone. But he should always be aware that the Paramatma is with him. And he can even go within the forests where all the wild happens, so everything is there. And in the same vein, there is the Yadvi Bheti Swayam Bhayam, even by chanting his name, fear runs away. So, if we don't have that faith, then if we run away because of some other's advice, then how to have that faith? So, unless one is, as you said, maybe Prabhupada's.
Only way to have faith is to have the understanding that you are seeing God in your heart. If you are associating with God, then you can go through anything. Just like I gave the example of Prahlad. He is seeing God, then he can do anything. So you understand God is in your... First of all, you must understand God is in your heart. Not only that, you must have a relationship with Him. Then yes, why you be frightened? No. So to come to that kind of a realization, advance, then yes, then you take sannyas or you go around naked or anything, nothing, no problem. Like Sukadeva Goswami, he is naked, he traveled. You travel like that, you know what happened to you? Huh? Correct. So you see, this is all depends on your level of advancement. You can theoretically understand God is in my heart. But when you accept the fact that He is in my heart and I am always having relationship with Him, like this verse, you know, in this 329, if you come to this level, then no problem. This verse, as the chariot of air carries an aroma from its source and immediately catches the sense of smell, similarly, one who constantly engages in devotional service in Krishna consciousness can catch the Supreme Soul who is equally present everywhere. You understand this point? Huh? Similarly, one who constantly engages in devotional service in Krishna consciousness can catch the Supreme Soul who is equally present everywhere. You understand this point? So if you are coming to this platform, then sannyas or no sannyas, it doesn't matter. You are always with God, then what's the problem? Correct? Yes? No problem. But if you are not, and you try to do, then of course you will be, you know what I mean? Can God in some fear, something? Yes? So we don't want to be in that position. Yes?
So the verse says, let the pain is fine in heaven. So whenever we are in a fearful situation, we can chant the holy name. But then the Raghunandas Goswami story is, we can't use the Lord for our protection. Our whole philosophy is not to use the Lord for our sake. And we should do our new diligence. Actually, that story of where Radharani covers him, that Sanatana Goswami's chastisement, then only the bhajan kutis all started. The culture of bhajan kutis, so that they will have this thing where they do their japa and all. So, our philosophy is that we don't disturb Krishna for our protection. But then here there are verses that we are fearful or anything, we immediately chant even Namaste Narasimhaya or Hare Krishna. So, why should we chant? We shouldn't chant during fearful
No, you see, the thing is that no, you try to use the Lord. You see, one is without humility. One is humility, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is going on the road, he is chanting Krishna, 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 Pahimam. Yes. And Krishna, Krishna, Rakshamam. Yes. He is God. Why is he? Why? So if you are humble, then you ask for the Lord for protection. In that mood, you understand, it's not out of the other mood, like the brahmachari going on the road. The Lord will protect me, I don't care anything. You understand? So humility, you are praying, you know, please you help me and you protect me. That is very much justified.
But Raghunandas
Goswami also wouldn't have been not humble. He's so humble, but he is, you know, because he's a pure devotee, just like the devotees, they don't want to disturb God. At the same time, Krishna also wants to take care of his devotees, as a pure devotees. You understand? This is the leela of God, you know. He also wants to reciprocate. But that's provided you are a, you know, pure devotee of the Lord, you know. If you are not a pure devotee, then that's another question. That's why as you surrender, I reward accordingly, the Lord says. How much your surrender is, that's another thing. You understand? So the devotee always feels himself that, no, if the Lord wills, he wants to help me, you know. But you're dependent on the Lord, it's always there. There's one verse, you know, that hoping against hope, right? You know, in 23 or 23, I think, Madhya 23, I understand that you will always give me shelter. And that hope is giving me a lot of pain, you know. There's one verse, I think it's 23, Madhya 23 something.
Who? Srivastaku.
Because
the Muslims, the Brahmins complain to the Muslims, they wanted to kill him. He was praying to the Lord Narasimhadev for protection. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came immediately and said, I am my Shivan.
Two different prayers, you know, pure devotee praying and a non. No, because we learn, no, that you cannot pray, you can always pray, nobody is stopping you to not pray. But the prayer should be, you know, with humility, as I say, please,
so like
my dear
Lord.
No, you want to commit suicide. Why give all trouble, you know? Of course, we don't say you don't pray. We are saying you please pray. Especially now, we all have to pray. But you should pray with humility, you know. My dear Lord, you please try to help me. The word please, try to help me, you know. Not that we demand. My dear Lord, you already said you will protect me. I am confident you will protect me. That's another way of thinking, you see. So, if you so desire, you please protect me. They all are different pure devotees. See, you should know, we should know our level. You understand? So a person who is a third class platform will be like the brahmachari. A person who is in the first class will be like Raghunath and all Srivas. Different. Especially the pure devotee, then Krishna, you know, he's for them. Krishna says, what is that verse? The devotees are in my heart and I'm in the heart of the devotee. I don't know anybody but my devotees, and devotees don't know anybody but me. The kind of level, you know, different level, you know. For us, we have a lot of other motives. We have conditions, we are motivated. So, I don't know about you, but definitely me, I'm not pure. And the Lord, I say, okay, I'm going to the virus zone, and please, my dear Lord, I would be more tactful, you know. You know, it's dangerous and you want to go, and then say, please Krishna, I'm going, you please. That's not talents. Okay, I take my example. I was in India, I was going out to preach, and I got a flight next day to go to Amalapuram and then to Calcutta and all that. Then, you know, instinct, of course, Krishna, you know, gave some realization. Say, better you go back now. And that proved the wisest, what we say, decision. And in fact, initially all the devotees were upset there. Now, Prabhu, why Prabhu, you come to Chennai, you know, no problem here. Now everybody is saying, Prabhu, you made the right decision. If I had not done it and say, no, Krishna will protect me and I've gone, I think you cannot come there, I cannot come, yeah, I'll be in the mess. You follow? There's intelligence, you know, just be fool. So, Krishna will help. You just have to surrender. How Krishna help? That's again. You have to use intelligence and see how Krishna to do that.
There was one incident where Rasikananda, Shamananda Pandit's disciple, he actually, villagers were all running out because of mad elephant. But he stood in front of the mad elephant and asked him to stop and preached to the elephant and made him a devotee, initiated him.
You can be Rasikananda, no objection. You please go and go to the, I think you are very much needed in America and Italy and all. You just go and zap everybody and that's it. I mean, they will worship you for sure. I think I'm not Rasikananda and I don't want to be in that category. I better be safe. All right. So it's getting late. Thank you very much. Grantharashman Bhagavatam ki. Srila Prabhupada ki. Oh, Premanandi.
One online question. One online question.
What question is that?
Why Ram is not called Purnavatar?
Why Nam is not called a Purnavatar? Because Ram is coming in the category of, you know, the his expansion of Krishna, you know, Rama Dimuteshu Kalanyamena Tisan Nana Avatar Akarod Bhuvaneshu Kintu is an expansion of an expansion. Whereas Krishna is Sampurna Bhagavan, is complete. You know, in that verse, Rama Dimuteshu Kalanyamena Tisan Nana Avatar Akarod Bhuvaneshu Kintu, Krishna Sambhavad Paraman Puman Yo. Is a different level. So Krishna's level is different, Rama's level is. Rama is an expansion of the four Chatur. Chaturvyaha, yes. The four personality, Narayana, or sometimes Vasudev, Pradyumna, Nurda, and Sankrishan. Vasudev, Pradyumna, Nurda, and Sankrishan. So he's in that category. That's why the four brothers, what is this? Ram is Vasudev, Lakshman is Shankarshan, Bharat is Anurda, and then the other person, Shatrughan is What is that? Anuradha and Pradyumna. So these four categories.
And you also said Narayana, Sankha Chakra and Sesha. Two different. And also in the relationships we can have with Ram is limited compared to Krishna. Like the sages in the forest, we wanted to have Ramsukal, but they cannot.
Hanuman, he wants master-servant relationship. Of course, Sita is different. She is an expansion of infinite potency. So, because the Lord... It's why Krishna had to come. And when Krishna comes, there's no conditioning for him. Whereas Lord Ram has some condition. He's a human being. He cannot do certain things. He used Hanuman to do all that. Of course, he can do also, but as a, you know, he limited himself. Whereas Krishna, he never limited himself. He showed himself as full, his full Purna avatar, you know, everything. He did things also that people are criticizing him, dancing with the gopis, you know. You know, that not man can do, ordinary man cannot do all these things. They show that how God is God. That's why he comes, different. So different, you know, roles. Okay, stop here then. No more questions. All glories to Prabhupada. Sri Ramachandra Bhagavan ki. Jai. Bol Prema.